y'all, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Thanks so much for stopping by. It has been a hot minute since I last uploaded, but if you follow me over on Instagram, then you would have seen on my stories that I did have family in town, and last week was the first week of summer vacation, so I was really kind of just putting social media on the back burner and just really absorbing time with friends and family. It was really nice. Today, I'm going to be sharing all of my favorite lifestyle and beauty products from the last month. I do kind of have just one random food favorite in here, but it's one that I've been loving, so I did want to share with y'all. So let's go ahead and just get right into it. The first product I have here is from the brand Pravana. You can find this at Ulta, or if your salon happens to be a salon that carries Pravana, then obviously you can find it there as well. This is the Intense Therapy Leave-In Treatment. It's 100% vegan, 100% gluten-free, supernatural color care. Now, if you are someone who is a fan of It's a 10, in my opinion, this is It's a 10 but better. Like, it kind of does the same sort of thing. It detangles, it hydrates. I'm not quite sure if it actually is a heat protectant or not, but I've been using it kind of as my heat protectant as well. So once I'm out of the shower, I like to let my hair partially air dry, and then I'll go in, spritz this in, really concentrate it more from like mid shaft to ends. I don't really ever like to go in with anything heavy on my roots, because then it's going to weigh my hair down. If you know me, I like big hair. Although today my hair is freshly washed, so it's a little bit flatter on the top. Day 2 and day 4 is like prime hair style days for me. I just feel like I get more volume then. But this has been amazing for me. I have both thick and coarse hair, and especially with longer hair, it's like past my boobas. I feel like my hair tangles at the nape of my neck just from the movement throughout the day. I will end up with like a straight up dreadlock. If I wanted dreadlocks, that would be great, but I just don't think I would really pull off that look. So I really need something that can go in and detangle. I really like the hydration that it gives, but it does all these things without adding additional weight to my hair. So that's the main reason that I like it. So when you first get it, it's one of those like bi-layer products. So once this fully settles, then it'll separate again. So before you go in and mist it in your hair, you just give it a good shake, and then it turns into this nice blue color. It is scented, but nothing like overpowering. It just smells like, honestly, all leave-in treatments kind of smell like Infusium 23 to me. I feel like I mentioned that product semi-recently on my channel, but yeah, I like it. It just like brings back memories from when my mom used to like rip through my hair. She always had to use that first. So see, I've always kind of had tangly hair. Okay, now moving on to makeup. I actually used this product in the last video that I uploaded, and ever since then, I've been using it pretty much every day that I've worn makeup. This is the Smashbox LA Cover Shot Eye Palette. It was recently on sale for $27 at Ulta. I'm not quite sure if that sale is still going on. I know during like the spring and summer, Ulta will do lots of like random products at 50% off. So inside you have a good mixture of, well, not that many, I guess mainly just like three colorful shades and then some really great neutrals. I love the brow bone shade. The main colors that I've been getting use out of though is this beautiful like red kind of terracotta shade. This shade in the crease, that's what I have on. I have both of these in my crease today. And then as well as this deeper shade, I do really like this kind of like gem toned purple and the gel liner in here. Whenever I first used this palette, I mentioned this gel liner. If you're looking for a great liner that does well both on your tight line and your waterline without smudging all over, this one is amazing. So yeah, I've been using this pretty much every single day. There's great neutrals in here. I have several of these Smashbox, are those ones just called the Cover Shot, the smaller palettes? I don't get too much use out of those, but I was surprised how much use I've been getting out of this. So this palette, as well as this guy here, I've been doing really good about going through my drawers and kind of like rotating and using other palettes that get neglected. And I rediscovered this one from Too Faced. This is the Razzle Dazzle Berry Eyeshadow Palette. This launched with the Tutti Frutti collection. I did an entire video on that. But this shade right here in this palette, don't get me wrong, all the purples and pinks in here are amazing, but this one, I'm not quite sure if it's like some sort of pressed cream. It kind of feels like one of the ColourPop Super Shock Shadows, but not quite as squishy. I should have used this on my eyes today, but I actually went in with the pineapple one instead, which surprisingly, when I first used the palettes, I thought I was gonna like this one more. Today, I have a mixture of these two shades. I kind of went in with this like softer gold first and then the intense gold right on top, just like in, well, this shade that I just swatched in the purple palette. This one is also kind of like that really nice silky squishy formula. The metallics in these palettes are amazing, especially the Razzle Dazzle one though. This shade here, if you love rose gold, you will love that color. This is actually another product that I used in my last video. Urban Decay sent over several of their new 24/7 glide-on pencils. This one is in the shade Wild Side. Even the packaging is so cute because the actual pencil portion of it is glittery, glittery. Wow, glittery like the product. This is a liner that you could use as like a cream shadow if you just wanted to go in and color it all on your lid. It's beautiful on the waterline, on your lower lash line. It's another like amazing coppery rose gold with just flecks of micro shimmer. I love this color so much. This would look beautiful on any eye color, but shades like this on like brown or hazel eyes, I feel like it just really makes them pop. So I always gravitate towards shades like this or like purple shades, anything that really enhances brown or hazel eyes, I love. And this one does it, so she makes me real happy. All right, I do have another kind of cream or liner product. I have been a huge fan of the Laura Mercier Caviar Sticks for years. In fact, Coco is one of my all-time favorites. I also love Smoke. I actually used that to create my little baby wings today. But this is one of her newer shades. It's called Intense Moonlight. I have some of this on my inner corner as well as my waterline. This does kind of fade on my waterline just because I have really watery eyes. But this as an all-over cream shadow is stunning. Look at that. It is so metallic and molten. It can be worn on its own, or if you wanted to go on top with any like kind of coordinating shade, for instance, this one in the pineapple palette I just mentioned. Let me just pick some up and we'll pat it on half. It can really just help intensify any sort of like coordinating metallic. But this one is so, so pretty. I keep promising an all cream product makeup look. I need to do that and I need to use this in that video just because I feel like this swatch isn't doing it enough justice. It is so beautiful. The next time you're in Sephora, go take your little puppy paw and give it a swatch and you'll see how stunning it is. I saw CoverGirl recently launched products that look like they're going to be a dupe for these. I went to the, like two different Walmarts hunting for them. I have not been able to find it yet, so. Do they carry those at Target? I don't know. I'll just have to order it online, but sometimes I love the thrill of like searching for things in store just because we do pretty much everything online these days. So I'm like, I just want to find it in person and put my little hands on it. Okay, next up is a K-Beauty product. This is from the brand Holika Holika. It's the New Drop Lumi Cheek. Just the name of it and the packaging, doesn't it remind you of like a L'Oreal Lumi product? This one is in the shade 1 Caramel Luster. I do have some of this on my cheeks right now. It's kind of like a blush and highlighter all in one. I guess that really also kind of depends on which shade that you get. But this really took me by surprise. I wasn't like, I knew it was going to be a cream product, but how do I describe it? It's not oily, but it's like a very slick, cream, lightweight product. Like there's no actual like greasiness or stickiness to it. It just kind of like slips and slides, but it applies beautifully on top of foundation without like disrupting what you have on your base. So sometimes I'll go in with my fingers. This last time I just used my sponge. So the sponge is dirty right now because I just used it. But I just want to give you all an example. I'll just bounce it right in here. So I'll get some on my sponge. Sometimes I'll blot off excess. And then I just bounce it right onto the high points of my cheeks. And it gives your cheeks just this beautiful, healthy glow. So I don't have any other highlighter on. It's just this product here. The way that it hits the light is so pretty. Especially if you're someone who likes really light makeup or tinted moisturizer, this would be a great product. Even if you have oily skin, I think you would still really like this because like I said, it doesn't feel greasy on the skin at all. And it doesn't stay sticky. I had mentioned the Kevin Aucoin Glass Skin, which I do still love. But I mentioned in that video, that is a product that stays sticky to where like if your hair gets in it, it sticks to it. This, it doesn't dry down to a powder, but it just doesn't stay wet either. It is such a nice product. I do kind of want to try out some more of the shades, but I think I did a great job picking my first one because it's a shade that kind of goes with any look that you're wearing. It's not too pink. It has a good amount of kind of like a rosy gold tone to it. So it's just almost like a neutral type of blush, even though it looks very pink in the pan. All right, moving on. My new favorite SPF. I still love the Super Goop Super Screen, right? Yeah, Super Screen and the Unseen Sunscreen. I've gone through bottles and bottles of this, but I really like products that are moisturizing too, especially if I have no makeup on my face. I started Camp Gladiator last week and I have been loving this for the mornings just because I want moisturizer on my face, but I don't want to have to worry about anything where like when I'm sweating, my face is going to feel slimy, but obviously I want SPF since I have nothing else on my face. And this serves kind of as my moisturizer and my SPF in one. The way that it makes my face look is just like so dewy, glowy, and healthy. Those are three traits that I love to have on my face. So the way that it applies, it's almost like a thicker emulsion. If you're used to like Asian beauty or like K-beauty skincare, you know, in your skincare steps, you have your essence, you have your emulsion, and it feels like that more so than a traditional sunscreen. It doesn't feel greasy. It doesn't feel heavy. When I sweat and it gets in my eyes, it's not like burning my eyes, because y'all, let me tell you, even though that class is at 7:45, it is so humid and hot here in Texas. So I'm sweating a lot. And some other sunscreens, although the Unseen sunscreen doesn't do it, but this is more of a smoothing, like almost primer-like sunscreen. I still love this, especially since it's clear and it's easy to rub right into the skin. But like I said, on some days I just want extra hydration, and this does it for me without feeling heavy and greasy. Did I have to tell you guys the brand? Whoops. It's a Sun Project Water Sun Cream, SPF 50 plus PA plus 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 plus. It's from the brand Thank You Farmer. I ordered mine on YesStyle. If you're looking for a great site to order a ton of different K-beauty, Japanese beauty, I think there's Chinese products, all sorts of different Asian skincare and makeup products, YesStyle has been my go-to. I'm really interested in trying some other products from Thank You Farmer. So if you guys have any recommendations, definitely let me know down below. That last favorite was kind of all over the place. I feel like everything is all over the place right now though. When I don't film for several days and then I sit down to film, I kind of get like overly excited, where it's just like, I'm blah, 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 90 to nothing. So yeah, there you go. For my final makeup product, this is from Huda Beauty. This is their Tantor Cream and Bronzer. I use mine in the shade Light, although when I'm looking at my face right now, I self-tanned after my shower and I use my regular foundation. So like, I feel like my face is really light compared to my body. Don't worry, I'll go in with the right foundation tomorrow. So I've been using the shade Light, and I do use it with the, what is this called? The Sculpt and Shade brush. You do have to purchase this separately. Obviously, you don't have to use this one. If you have a cream foundation or cream contour brush you love already, you can go in with that. But I really like this just because it's 2-in-1, especially if you do want to go in and contour your nose or really go in and chisel areas of your cheeks and then use the other side to buff it out. I just love this because it blends out so easily. It creates a very nice, natural, warm contour. Nothing too harsh. Like I said, it is a bronzer and contour in one, so none of the shades are overly cool. It's just more of a natural like warmth to your face, which is what I love. For the last several months, I haven't really been going in with actual like contour shades. I'm someone who really loves like warm bronzers. I know some people don't really love an orangey bronze. I do. I just feel like it kind of suits my skin tone. I like the look of it. And sometimes with actual contouring shades, it's really easy to pick one up that's too ashy, to where you end up with like a bruised cheeks rather than warmth. It's just like, did you get punched in the face? And is that why you're looking chiseled? So this has been working great for me. The pan size looks small just because this is so shallow, but a little bit really does go a long way. Like, I will only have to dip in 2 times to do my whole face, and then half the time I'm still left with quite a bit of product left on the brush. Don't judge that too harshly. It needs to be washed. For my food favorite, I actually pulled this out because I wanted this one at room temp today, but I love these refrigerated as well. If you follow me on Instagram stories, you would have heard about these already. These are the Built Bar Protein and Energy Bars. They have 110 calories, 15 grams of protein, 6 grams of fiber, 4 grams of sugar, and 4 grams of fat. If you're doing Weight Watchers, these are 3 points. And let me tell you, these taste exactly like a candy bar. I am someone who is so picky and like sensitive to that protein taste. I've tried so many that other people recommend, like the Think Thin bars. There's another Quest bars. I feel like so many people love Quest bars. I eat that and I taste that weird protein aftertaste. I can't get down with that. I feel it on my tongue and it's just like thick, and I can't do it. I don't like it at all. The one that I have right now is coconut chocolate cream. I also love the orange one. If you guys love those Terry's oranges, you know, the ones that you like slam on the counter and bring it to wedges. Oh, those are so good. It honestly tastes just like that. And then the double chocolate is really good too. Also, these are gluten-free, so if you do have a gluten intolerance, you can still enjoy these. So this is what they look like. I'm totally gonna take a bite so y'all can see the inside. But the outside is like actual chocolate. There's none of that weird fake chocolate taste. And this one, if you slice it into like 4 or 5 pieces and push a raw almond into it, it's like an Almond Joy. It is so, so good. So let me go ahead and break it open. It's like a nougat on the inside. Oh, that wasn't, I should have bit it instead. This is like a mukbang now. I probably have chocolate on my teeth. But I'm telling y'all, The chocolate flavor on these is so good. Make sure I don't have chocolate all over my teeth now. I really don't know how people film those mukbangs. I felt weird even just eating on camera for that like short period of time. This portion isn't sponsored. I just wanted to share it. If you happen to be on like dietary restrictions and you're looking for a tasty treat, that one is definitely one that I would recommend. I do get a small kickback if you guys use my coupon code. It's just Dana in all caps. You get 10% off as well as free shipping, but by no means feel pressured to use that. I just thought I would hop on here and share because it's something that I've really been enjoying. And yeah, I think that is it for my favorites. As always, thank you so much for spending part of your day with me. If you haven't already, I would love if you subscribe. That way we can hang out more in the future. And yeah, I will catch y'all in the next one. Bye.